Hello everyone, my name is Tootie Hall. I am with Acclaim, with Acclaim Talent, but I am with the network Austin Mixer with Gary Wimmer. I'll be followed by Gary Wimmer.
Well, thank you folks for joining us. This is indeed a special mixer. I met Donise about, 15 years ago. She joined the network Austin Mixer and has brought such a degree of professionalism and talent. And we're so thrilled with that. And tonight, this is a special dedication, a celebration of life to Donise. Now, I would like to turn it over to Veronica.
Thank you so much, Gary and Tootie. I want to say thank you to the Austin Network Mixer and both of you for allowing me to come on and kind of create this opportunity for everybody to celebrate Donise Hardy. And for those that don't know, Donise was one of my best friends for over 20 years. I used to own DVA Talent, and I walked into her office one day with chocolate-covered macadamia nuts and said, I want you to see my talent. And we've been best friends ever since. As a matter of fact, as I'm going through her things and taking care of things, I found the thank you card that I sent her that many years ago. So, and that was something that I thought you all should know, because as we all come together to celebrate this amazing casting director and woman, I wanted you to know that every moment that you thought of her and showed your appreciation, she kept it all. She has all of your thank you cards, all of your Christmas cards, all of your announcements about success in the industry, all of your just everything. She loved all of you and this industry so much. She didn't want to miss a thing. And she always wanted to remember it. And so when you get into this industry, it can be really tough when you come up with casting directors or really anybody in the industry to find out, where do I stand? Do they like me? Do they not? I mean, it's all such a thing. With Donise, you always knew. She was not afraid to share with you what she thought, what she felt, but she always came from a place of goodness and love for you and this industry. And I'm going to play something for you guys here a little bit for many of you that, you know, knew Donise, but you guys know her in the industry sense. I was very fortunate. She compartmentalized a lot of her life. And I was very fortunate to sort of be on the four corners of it all. And her friends, Joan and Ellie and Pato, Carolyn, Bob, Hummel, Carl, Audra, Ellen, Diane, and her dear, dear friends, Susan and Alan Syme, who really helped her the last several years. And her brother, Patrick, and his son, Stephen, and her nephews, Justin and his brothers, and her sister, Sandy, who passed many years ago, all were important parts of her life, but you guys were all intertwined in that. And she and I spoke many years ago about the possibility of today. And she told me what she would love is to see all of your faces, hear stories, and hear music. And I will apologize now if I cry a bit during this moment. I miss my friend. I miss her greatly. And to have all of you here tonight shows how incredibly blessed she was to have all of you. And I see Christopher Tellis here. Hi, Christopher. So if with your permission, I would like to share that video that you posted. You good?
It's Donise's. It wasn't mine. So of course.
I know. Yeah. So I just want to say, so I would like to share something with you all really quick. And then I want to hear from you. Give me just a moment as I bring on my super techie self. Ha ha ha. Give me a moment.
Hi, my name is Donise Hardy, and I'm a casting director based in Austin, Texas. Proudly a member of the Casting Society of America since 1993. I've experienced many facets of the industry, and I want to share my knowledge with you. Starting as a model, working my way up to pageants, from the pageants being an extra, being a principal actor, being an extra's casting director, and being a casting director. I grew up in the pageant system in South Florida. Then I went on to move to San Francisco, where I subsequently became an extra on a TV show that happened to be Donise. And it was a wonderful experience, so much so that I decided I was an actor. So I immediately got an agent and started working. I shot several TV commercials, did a lot of print work, and had speaking roles on three different television shows. That was my SAG card, and I was very, very proud of it. After being an actor for a long time, I decided to go to the other side of the camera, where I became what's known as a baby booker. It's a talent agent that represents babies that are 15 days old, up to about 5 years. In 1991, two dear friends of mine in the Bay Area approached me to be a third partner in what became the Bay Area's largest casting agency. So we were casting principals and having a wonderful time. I didn't have pets, plants, kids, husbands, boyfriends, or anything. So I worked and cast in Los Angeles for approximately 6 years until a little event called the Northridge earthquake that took care of me. At that time, I started teaching workshops. After the earthquake, I was talking to my sister, and she said, gee, you've been in California for 30 years all by yourself. If you're going to move, why not move to Texas? So I thought, why not? Why not? So for the last 15 years, I've been in
You probably, maybe you shouldn't play it on high HD. It might go a little faster.
And to all you folks listening, I will edit in the original video of this so it'll be synced with sound.
Be happy with what you find.
As you can see, our girl had quite the career. And I'm going to try and make sure that I get rid of that before I do something crazy. Hold on. There we go. Hold on. There we go. I have a few folks that have sent in some things, but I want to say this to you guys, because we have a lot here tonight. If you feel like sharing something in the chat, I see it. We've got a message there now. Please, please post with full sound. Peggy, I'm sorry if that didn't come through. Okay, we'll make sure we get that. But please leave your love notes to Donise and on the chat, because we can save this chat. And for those that want to see that link, go to Donise's Facebook page, because I believe I've saved it there. And if I haven't, I will later on today, or later on this evening, so you can watch it. And I'm going to turn it over to you, Tootie and Gary, to call on folks. And then I've got a few more things towards the end. Thank you all so much for being here.
Thank you, my dear. Now, we do have a lot of participants, more than any mixer. So I'm going to ask you all to, under reactions, to raise your hand if you want to make a comment. And after you make a comment, lower your hand. I'm going to take them in the order we see them, because otherwise alphabetical order is going to be a real pain. So raise your hand like I did here and lower your hand when we finish your comment. So I can't see any hands raised yet, but feel free to. Okay, Sonny, we're going to come on in, brother. Can you unmute yourself, Sonny?
I started off acting many years ago. Donise was one of the first people that I met, and everybody was like, she's so mean, and yet she was one of the nicest people that I'd ever met. It was cool because she would call me in for auditions all the time, and she never booked me. And then finally she called me, she was like, hey, do you want to work? And I was like, I sure do. And she's like, cool, come be my cameraman. So then we got to kind of hang out with, watching her help people audition and stuff like that. And just learning from the behind the camera from her was a real good experience. And she kind of helped me as well. Like, hey, you know, you're a ghetto person. There's certain things you can't do in Hollywood. You gotta calm down. So, it was real nice having her by my side early on. And, I still entertain people as much as I can today. And a lot of what I learned from her, I still take it with me. So rest in peace, Donise.
Thank you, brother. We have iPhone here. Can you hear me, iPhone? Don't have a picture up. Is the iPhone? There you are.
Yes. This is Angela Benavides Garza. Had a lot of self-esteem challenges. Donise had a way of pulling the best out of you. She just, you know, no matter what you did, when you went to the networking group, when Judith and Donise were there and Tootie were there, such a supporting team, Gary, everybody there. You know, it's not an easy business. It's not easy. And you go through a lot of no's before you get to your yes. And every, you know, she just made everything seem so special. Whatever improvement you made, whatever small thing you did, learned so much on film sets, just the wealth of information she would put us in front of, putting people in front of people that were casting. And I mean, she just had a huge heart for people. And sometimes she was tough because she knew the business was tough, right? And I just have such a respect and regard for her. Driving with Judith, you know, even young people to be so successful as well, introducing them to open doors, and then driving the solution for the Texas funding as well as a legislation where we would sit at the restaurant to come up with legislation to open more doors for people in all these creatives. And it was just everything about her. She was just so amazing. And I am shocked. I'm still shocked and trying to let this get around my head, but rest in peace, Donise. We love you. We love everything you've done here. I'm so proud that I've known her, Angela Benavides Garza. Thank you.
Absolutely. And thank you, iPhone. Shauna, Leah, you're up next. Please unmute your mic and let us hear what you have to say about our beautiful friend.
Hi, it's Shanna.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. But yeah, I actually I'm from San Francisco, and Donise was had just started into casting then way back. And then I never thought that I would be coming here to Austin, but here I am. And she was one of the most beneficial people by taking her class for auditioning for commercials, and really I appreciated having somebody that would give feedback and was kind of like the mom of everyone, of getting them to know of like what you do. And while she, you know, I appreciate so much of having somebody who would be able to tell it to you straight and not just either no feedback or to not really tell you points to constructive criticism, and you know, she was integrated here in Austin very well. And I was surprised that she wasn't a native of Texas, but I remembered her from back there because her name is unusual, and you know, mine is too. So and it still is very shocking that she's gone. It's weird of just seeing that video of her talking. It's like she just seems like that you know, like it'll take a while to come to realize that she's gone. And
let's always remember the continuity of life.
Yes. Yeah.
Even true. If we don't see it, we know it's continuous. Look at nature. So
she's in the stardust now.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, my dear.
Thank you, Gary.
Donise and Jason, help yourself and everybody else, please mute. Thank you.
Hello. One of the things that I just wanted to say about Donise is that I hope she knows how many people she brought together who became good friends through her classes and through the mixers. Like, and I just said like, which I know she hated. but she just meeting people in her class, and then you go to the mixers and you see them there and you became friends. And I hope that she knows how many friendships started because of her. And that's all I wanted to say. Jason, you want to say anything?
Yeah. I've known Donise pretty much almost as long as she's been in Texas. And I'll tell you guys, one thing that you probably don't know is behind the scenes, she was a fierce advocate for her students. She would send me feedback, which is really unusual these days. Right up to the very end, she would send me feedback on students that she liked and things that she didn't like and what she wanted to see. And also, she was a real fighter to keep the unscrupulous folks out of our world. I remember having conversations with her about John Robert Powers, who was a bad player in this industry. Some of you may know who he is, some of you may not. But she was always on your side. Rest in peace, Donise. Thanks for all that you did. I'll miss you at the mixers when I start coming back.
Thank you so much. Heartfelt, love y'all. Love what you do, Jason. Terrence, looks like you're the next up. Please tell us your favorite Donise impression, feeling, or thought.
All right, well, good evening, everyone. For me, I just feel incredibly grateful to have taken her classes, because I looked to see when I took her first one, and I saw that it was actually January of 2020, so right before the pandemic. So it's crazy to think that I was able to do that before then. And then her advanced class, I took that last year as soon as she was able to start doing the in-person classes. And I just feel incredibly grateful to have taken her classes, and I learned a lot. She was one of the first teachers that I heard a lot about in terms of, if you need training for commercials, go to Donise. So I knew I had to go and take her class, and I just really enjoyed it. I enjoyed her. She gave me great feedback. And I feel like any commercials that I book now is because of her. It's because she guided me and set me on the right path. So just incredibly grateful for her, grateful for her life, and just rest in peace to Donise. Just really appreciate everything that she's done for not only myself, but everyone else and just the Austin acting community. So thank you, Donise.
Thank you, Terrence. God bless, man. She was a gem. Still is. Michael Druick, you're up next, brother. Good to see you, man.
Good to see everyone. Wish it was under different circumstances. But I am smiling because I do see a room full of people who we've all known each other for a long time. And Donise is a big part of that. She was a uniter of people. And I miss those good old days, you know, when I was, everyone knows those days, you know, back in the old Alliance days, and just, you know, it was just a different ball game in Austin. Everyone just seemed so much more approachable, but she treated everyone with such respect. I was a little wet behind the ears, agency intern. Some of you are nodding because you remember me those days. And you know, I guess respect, that's just the word I keep going back to, because, you know, she just was there, you know, the whole journey for me, from, you know, when I exited that journey and started a new journey. She didn't feel threatened. She wasn't like, oh, you want my job, or anything like that. She even up until her last years, I was so honored to be an associate for her when she would do an occasional job here and there, and just relearned how to do it the right way. And I kind of miss those days. I'm going to miss them, and I'll remember everything from, you know, knowing your sizes and your size sheets to having your headshot at the callback. Like, everything she was saying is still relevant today. And in fact, I even have her book here. So I'll try this. I haven't taken it out of my bag in 3 years. I just took it out just right now to take a look, and it's going to go back in my bag. One quick little anecdote I just love that always just takes the pressure off. Good old extras casting days. Thank God I don't do as much of it these days, but I know she started her casting career doing that. And I love the story of the rotary phones and, you know, before cell phones and them pushing the call time at like a 5 a.m. call time or something like that. And she had like something like 100 extras booked in the cornfields of San Francisco. And then what is she supposed to do at 1 a.m. when they pull the call time? And she just shows up at the regular time and tells everyone, why the hell are y'all here so damn early? So that just taught me, you know, just don't sweat the small stuff, even the big stuff. Just it'll all get done. And I guess that's something I'll carry with me along with the many, many lessons she taught me and the friendship she gave me. And one more thing, Lee, I love that you're here, Lee Green. And thank you for telling me about everything. But when I first heard the news and I was just pouring my heart out to her and thanking her for keeping us all together, you, Veronica, you, Gary, you, Tootie, you know, she said you did her proud. And I will never forget that. Thank y'all. Love y'all.
Thank you so much, Michael. Heartfelt, true, and you're right. She had quality. She had class. Fazia, is that correct?
That is correct. See if I can do this without crying. like Jason said, she really was a very strong advocate for actors in Austin. I remember when I was a brand new actor, had almost nothing on my resume. I found out about her class and I took it. And I knew the moment she thought I had what it took to do auditions, because right after that, my agent at the time suddenly started sending me out. I knew that she had actually taken the time to go pick up the phone and talk to him and say, hey, send her out for those kinds of things. She made me a professional. She is such a good teacher. That is a real rarity in all of the training classes that you can find out there. A true teacher, somebody who takes something that's a mystery and makes it not a mystery, makes you understand the whys and wherefores of it. And she took that mystery out of it and made auditioning not scary and much easier to do. And Veronica, she reminded me of my best friend, who was very much like her, you know, warm and friendly and helpful, but also brooks no fools and tells it like it is. I will relate one story. I saw her once in front of the Paramount Theater in downtown Austin. I was going to something else and she was coming back from teaching a class, and we met on the sidewalk and we chatted for a little bit about what I was doing, what she was doing and things like that. And I had gained a little weight. So I was starting to go to auditions wearing one of those kind of Spanx kind of things. And she was just chatting with me and everything. And before we were about to leave, she looked me in the eye and she reached out and she put her hand on my belly and she went. And I never did that again. She knew and she was telling me she'd seen it. So, but she was always so supportive. And yeah, I'm going to miss her. Thank you.
We all miss her. But again, she's always in spirit, always in spirit. Brandy, tell us your story.
Well, first of all, greetings from Seattle, Washington. I am unfortunately no longer in Texas, but of course we know that Donise and her, can you all hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. You sound
amazing. Just wanted to make sure I was not muted. Of course we know Donise and her spirit and everything worldwide. I just want to say that I love the fact that she was a straight shooter. She was extremely kind, extremely loving. I don't think the word respect can be said enough. I think we all respected her. And one of the reasons that I respected her so much is because she told it like it was, but she did it with love. And she knew those that, and she knew people, the people that she interacted with, the lives that she touched, she knew those people. And so she knew who needed a little extra coddling when she gave them her words, and those who she can just let them know and they understood. And the fact that they were all said with love always, I will forever love her. My career started in Texas and she was one of the first people that I was fortunate enough to interact with. So I will forever remember her and be grateful for all that she did for the Texas acting community. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, sweetheart. And Texas would love to have you back.
I would love to come back. And I think I might do that.
God bless you. Peggy, good to see you, my dear.
Hello. Hello, Gary. Wonderful to see you and everyone. You know, I just wanted to say I started acting later in life. And one of the first things I did and one of the best things I did was to sign up to take Donise's audition prep class. And I tell you what, she was tough, but she needed to be, because what she did was prepared all of us and gave us the confidence to go into an audition room, commercial audition room, and know, and I see all these hands up and I'm just thinking about, you know, how to do our hands. And the things that I learned from her in that very, very first class. And then over the years, the more experience I got and people would ask me for advice, you know, what do? How do you get started in the business? And I would say, number one, you need to get into class, and a class you absolutely have to take is Donise's class. Always, always recommended her because, you know, she served the Austin acting community so, so well and had such an impact on so many people through her classes and through the mixer. I mean, I would love to come to the mixer. Gave us an opportunity to meet everyone and just be, you know, on pretty much on the same level. You always look at casting directors and agents as, you know, people you can't approach, but she helped to make it, and you all with the mixer helped to make it to where, you know, we could approach them and be together with other actors. And that meant so much, so much to us. And I just want to say, I know, as I recall, Donise was a fan of vodka. I don't have any vodka, but I just wanted to lift a glass and toast to Donise and thank her so much for all she did for all of us.
Wait, Peggy, you are my favorite. Yes. Everybody at this moment, I will do this a couple more times. Sorry, Gary, but I got to jump in on this one. So everybody,
there's the vodka.
We got the Donise crew here. I'm just saying. Raise a glass, water, juice, whatever you have. She would appreciate it all. And this is to our girl.
Cheers. To Donise.
Thank you, Peggy. God bless. Zoom user, you are up. Don't know your name, but under Zoom user, tell us your Donise story. You there, Zoom user? Unmute yourself.
Is that me?
Well, you're on. Go ahead.
Okay. Hello. My name is Gustavo Pena. I'm doing Zoom through a browser, so I didn't know if you were referring to me or not, but sorry if I went in front of anyone. But I first met Donise last year in the latter part of 2021, or a couple years ago, and I was terrified. I was taking her her class, her beginner's class. And I was so terrified because I had heard stories about her. I had read her book. I was like ready for her, but at the same time I was terrified, but I knew I had to give her my best. And, you know, I went into her class, you know, knees shaking, had butterflies and everything. And she could instantly like spot my fear for some reason. Like I felt like she instantly knew that I was terrified, but she calmed me down and she told me just to relax, just to go through the motions and to still follow her directions. And sure enough, not only did I, I don't want to seem cocky, but like I gained her approval. Like she told me, Gus, she's like, what you just did in front of me is amazing. And when she said that to me, I felt like this was my calling. Like I felt like I was on the right track, because you know, someone of her stature in her class, you know, complimented me in such fashion meant the world to me. And of course, when I took her advanced class, I was ready for her and I was ready to blow her away, and gosh, I did. And those are the memories I'll keep with me. And I love you so much, Donise. I know that you're listening to me right now. And I just want to say thank you for everything you taught me. And I'll try to make you proud.
I think you probably have, gosh. I think you have made her proud. Okay, I'll let y'all know the order. Myrna, you're going to be next, then Mary Jane, and then Step. Zoom user, I'll get back to you in a minute when you're ready. But right now is Myrna.
I can't Myrna. Read it.
Excuse me, my glasses are...
It's okay. I see some people I know. Hi, guys. I'm Myrna Cabello. I left Austin 9 years ago. I'm in New York City. And I started off way... Some of y'all remember me? I started way back when Donise came in town. And I remember the talk about, oh, my gosh, a new casting director. And I'd heard stuff like, oh, she's like... You know, somebody had mentioned that she was mean or that she was tough or that she was, you know, and I was like, so scared. And I was like, I got to get my shit together when I go in there. So I like went in there as professional as I could be and met her, saw the angel on her back. And I'm like, these stories, I'm not sure, right, to what I'm hearing. So I would go in and I was not chatty. I'd be like, I'm not wasting your time. I'm just going to go in, do my thing. Thank you very much. Bye. Sorry, guys. She gave me a lot of opportunities, and I know that I wouldn't be where I'm at if it wasn't for her. She is partially responsible for that. There was a time when... I got Bell's palsy, and I was paralyzed on the right side of my face, and I withdrew from acting for a while, and I didn't know what, you know, I was going to do. I was like, okay, well, that's out the window. And she called me in for an audition, and I had just started recuperating, and I was so scared, but I went in and did my audition. And I let her know, I said, I'm recovering from paralysis. And her reaction, man, she was just an angel. She just like hugged me. And she said, I didn't notice. You're doing good. You're doing good. You're getting better. And we had this long talk. And that's when she just, it went from looking at her as a casting director to a friend and somebody that's there for you and that has your back and that is going to support you all the way. And even though I moved to New York City, on my posts, she would post and she would tell me that she was watching me and that she was proud. And I did tell her, but I want to tell her now. Thank you so much for everything and for believing in me and for being such an angel to so many people. I love you.
God bless you, sweetheart. I'm going to take 1 second and mention some, probably a few folks don't know. I am one of the luckiest people on the planet because in 1977, I had a near-death experience. I'm on a lot of radio shows, TV shows, Zoom meetings. And the one thing I can attest to is the continuity of life. You know, we go on and go on and go on. But our intentions, when you love someone, when you think good, when you give good intentions, that matters. So your heart comes through there, my dear. Intentions are worth it. She hears. Trust me. Mary Jane, won't you let us... in on some of your precious moments.
Hi, everyone. Besides, of course, just taking her classes, and like Peggy said, I was advised to do that, and I did it, and I'll never, ever be able to convey how important that was for me, just as a person, a woman, and being older and growing up in a time when, you know, we're not supposed to assert ourselves because we're girls and we're supposed to just, you know, and she helped me so much. I had the worst agent ever. And when I told her who it was, her face fell off practically. And she said, I'm not leaving your side. I am not going to let you stay with that person. And you come to the Austin Mixer. It was the first one I ever went to. And I found my new agent, and she helped me extract myself from this horrible situation. I mean, I was getting less than half of my fee. And it kept going down, and she wasn't going to let that happen. And she just, I mean, brutally honest on headshots, and years go by, and hey, I got some new ones, and what do you think? I couldn't find the right turquoise top, you know, turquoise. We all had to, you have to wear turquoise or green or, you know, and I'll just never forget how she empowered me and gave me the courage and the belief in myself that I can do this. I'm freaking doing it. And she is why. And so, along with all the other beautiful things everyone has said, another toast to our dear friend and our angel. God bless you, Donise. I'm so sad that you're gone.
And she would have been so proud of you.
Mm-hmm. Well spoken, girls. Well spoken. And God bless. Step, we know you have some comments about magical Donise. Please share with us, my dear.
Hi, everybody. It's so strange seeing a lot of you. I was Donise's first assistant, and I was trying to think of what can I say in less than 60 seconds. So I was like, the night we met Quentin Tarantino, no, when Spike Lee was doing stuff, no, when that weird redheaded woman came in and said she was a new agent, what was her name, Veronica?
You were on the thank you card I sent that she kept, by the way. It said to Donise and Steph.
Oh, but I don't know if you guys know, in May, she came to the high school where I was teaching drama, and I just, on a whim, I asked her if she wouldn't mind coming to talk to my class, and she did, and it was just so great to reconnect with her, and she sent me the nicest text afterwards. It just, I had to pull over and cry. That's how much I had missed her. But I decided to say that back in, I think it was 2000 or 2001, there was a strike, and we weren't working because the actors weren't working. And so we had to move out of 501 and do casting out of her apartment. And we were having lunch one day, and I was opening like a can of lentil soup. And she's like, what are you eating? I was like, it's lentil soup. And she's like, no. I make the best lentil soup. So tomorrow I'm making you lunch. Just come at the regular time, but we'll have a long lunch. And it was so intimate and so sweet. And I just, like y'all say, she came out of the gun, you know, I'm a professional, but I will scare the pants off you and make you raise your game. And it was so motherly and warm that she made me lunch. And it was such a beautiful thing, you know, especially at a time when we were struggling and she, you know, didn't have a lot of work. And it was like, we had to be people. And so I'll always remember her as like mama in a way. So it was great to see her so recently. And like I said, she was in her element sitting. I put a camera on her and put a big screen behind her. So, you know, she looked like she was on the big screen, and these kids were just like, and I tried to tell them afterwards, you have no idea how lucky you are to have this woman come talk to you, but teenagers, what did they know? So that was the story I thought I would tell you guys about Donise.
Gary, if I may jump in for just a moment to say to Steph, she told me she was so excited to come and talk. First of all, she was so excited to do this for you. And she was so excited to talk to your students. She didn't like the background check, but whatever. It's fine. You know how she got. But that said, thank you for inviting her. You and I know. She loved nothing more than to be able to share her knowledge so that people could be successful of all ages. But to be able to speak to kids was something that
was so dear to her heart. And the fact that you asked her to come and do this meant so much to her. And I just want you to know that. So thank you.
Beautiful girl, beautiful. I had a very short acting career. I'm a musician, been my whole life. Got into acting about 2002 until about 2006 or seven. About the time that I was a year or two into the mixer, I quit acting for a lot of reasons. But thank God, when Donise joined the mixer, it brought a level of professionalism and talent and passion and professional people, because I was not in the field very long. But so my heart goes out to every day. Thank you for keeping us all amped up and inspired and sharing your wisdom with us. Now, Carl, you have something to say about it, I'm sure. Help yourself, brother. We're going to hear from you.
I do. I'm glad to see one here. It's been a while. I haven't been, since I moved from Austin, but I'm having a great time down here in Rockport, Texas. So if anyone want to come down to the beach, feel free to come down and say hi. I first started out in this acting arena probably 1991 on a TV series called Young Writers. I don't know if anybody old enough to remember that show, but that was my first start. And I thought that I knew pretty much everything, which of course I didn't know anything. And I started taking some classes with Donise probably 2013. And she was tough. She was really tough, but she was tough and she was kind. And through all the years, I will look to her and listen to her, especially at the mixers, because she taught me so much about, what should I do? Getting agents and all those different types of things. I bought her book. Well, actually, I didn't really know anything about the book until I saw it somewhere. So I sent her a message and said, I would really love to have that book. So she sent me the book. And of course, I don't have it right here in my hand, but yes. And I read it all the time. And I'm going to miss her because one other thing that she always do, we were Facebook friends. And I post all kind of weird, funny things, pictures of birds and trees and whatever, and mostly about my dogs. And she would always comment. She always had a comment. Or like, and I'm gonna miss seeing that light from her. So, Denise, rest in peace.
Thank you, Carl. Everybody who's met her has similar feelings. Even if she's a little bit tough sometimes, you gotta admit, you respect her because she's usually right. She's tenacious, she has soul, she is compassionate, she does feel. But she can turn on some fire too. God bless her.
That's exactly what I was about to say. You just took the words out of my mouth.
Tell us more, dear. Keep going.
Oh, it's me. Oh, yep. Hi. Okie dokie. Oh, hello. I'm Michelle McGonigal. I have had the honor of meeting Donise when my sister was coming to be a guest speaker at the mixer. So my mother and I and my little sister, we went to go, see my sister speak. But Donise came up when she got on that stool and sat down and started speaking, just in between her first introduction. And she was just like, "Hey, honey, go ahead and give me another refill." And when I heard her say that and had someone bring out that drink, I was like, I love her. I was enchanted. I was like, I want to be that someday. I was like, she just said what she wanted. She's got it. And she's like, what? But anyway, so my sister, Marta Cross, that's my sister. She introduced me to Donise and everyone. And once Donise got to know what I was doing, I was just starting up my business, my business is Umbrella Media. I do website design and marketing. And I was just starting out then. This was 13 years ago. Anyway, as soon as my sister, you know, introduced us and said, this is what my sister does, you know, and she was just like, she's like, you know what? I love you. You're going to do my website. That's it. That's all she, I mean, that was it. I was like, I didn't even have to sell myself. I was like, okay, great. And so whenever you, Flazia, I'm sorry about the names, but you said that she made me a professional. You were so on cue because she did make me a professional that day too. She helped me. She had that, that faith in me and that motivation. She's been loyal ever since, you know, and I've loved her for that. So not only was she wasn't just a client, but she was a friend, she was family, the love and these, especially these past 2 years, I have been personally going through some hard times in my personal life, unfortunately. And I'm not gonna name names or hint at whatever it is, but just say that there's a certain person that's no longer in my life. And Donise had a lot of strong words against that person and helped me through it. Tell me that you're strong, you can get through this. Don't let him bring you down. And it's like, no matter what she was going through in her life, we would talk on the phone for like a couple hours, and it was just about her trying to let me know that it'll be okay, this will pass. Anyway, so God, I love her. Anyway, so the last conversation I had with her, she was telling me what had happened with her, and I was just like, Donise, I want to send you some flowers or something. She's like, Michelle, do not send me flowers. If you do, I'm going to be pissed off. And I was just like, okay, cancel order. And so I just want to say, Donise, I didn't bring flowers either right now, nothing, but anyone who's ever had the honor of being graced with her presence, you know, to meet her and have her in your life, you're truly blessed by such a strong, beautiful person who, you know what she does, like everyone said, you know, when she says something, you have to follow suit. You don't say no to Donise. You're like, she's like, oh, that's why I said delete on the flower order. You have to follow what she says, but she tells it how it is. And she's so, she helped me to become a stronger person, just knowing her throughout my life. Donise, I love you. I'm going to miss you. And you know what? Here's the vodka. Cheers to you, Donise.
I need to say, sorry again, I'm jumping in, Gary. So Michelle, I know you through Donise, and I got the Golden Girls here. We got our bats. We're ready to go. Just so you know, somebody's going to get it. Somebody's going to get it. And I will say this. She loves you. Oh, wait. Okay.
I have to tell you something. Because it's going to be perfect with what you're... Hold on.
Please be a baseball. And while you're getting it, I'm going to say this. She loved you. And the thing about, for everybody to know, loyalty was such a big thing to Donise.
You gotta have the purse.
Oh. Yes. Now it's okay, so I didn't have you to know that. You know, she has passed you on to us. Yeah. We got you. Okay, moving on, Gary. Thank you.
Okie dokie. God bless you, Michelle. By the way, I have pictures of you and your sister and Dorian at the mixer.
Yes.
On Mother Egan's.
You do?
Yeah, if you will email me, gw@garywimmer.com. I'll send them to you.
Yes. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I have those pictures. Wow. And by the way, Doran and I wrote a TV series, El Zora Plata. Your sister.
Really?
Yeah, and he was wanting your sister to play a lead role in it. Furthermore, Donise did her best to try to sell that for us, but without a real agent, you know, it's hard in Hollywood. But we submitted it a lot, and Donise helped us. And Dorn and I wrote it because he did all this black ops stuff and wanted
his book series.
A lot of connections.
I have his whole book series. Yeah. Oh my gosh, I have no idea.
Actually, Dorn ended up writing a lot of books recently.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I have like five of his books. Like,
yeah, well, some of those characters, like Jens, who weighs his cereal, I created those characters and put them in the screenplay. And when he put those in the book, I went, great, because we didn't sell the screenplay, but you're putting it to use. So,
can I also say this too? Like, I'd love to just say, just speaking of which, if it's okay, also rest in peace, Dorn, because he was also a huge impact in my life as well. And he was so magnificent. He helped me through so much, you know, just, I still have his old, his military hat he gave me, gave me a Lane chest and all these things. And also he helped me with the personal issues for the past couple of years. So both of them were like in my life at the same time, helping me both of them, such great souls, great spirits, just wonderful, beautiful people that really cared and really had the intention and the real truity of wanting to really do to help you instead of, you know, before themselves.
Dorn was a good guy. We were polar opposites.
Yeah. Oh.
Donise and I are polar opposites, but Dorn and Donise and I.
It's a yin and yang, right?
The three oddballs, you know.
Yeah. Right. Well, that's what makes life so interesting, right?
Thank you for your participation. Veronica, I want to open it.
Thank you for letting me be honored to be here. Girl. I'm just honored.
Thank you. Carrie, do you want to make some comments first? We got you up here.
Thank you. Just really quick. So I had to get my notebook out. I met Donise. I'm in Dallas, by the way. And I met Donise in March of 2011, shortly after I got an agent here. She's like, you have to go take commercial auditioning with Donise. That was just like required. And I was just reading through the notes and all the things that I do now and I learned from her. And I did hear, you know, that she was kind of tough and everything. But when I went down there, I had so much fun. We laughed and had a ball. And everybody in the class just enjoyed her so much. And so that whole myth about her being tough, it just, you know, I could tell she was serious, but at the same time, like everybody said, she wanted you to do your best. She was hardcore advocate for actors. And there's just nobody I've ever met like her and never will probably. But just reading through some of this stuff, I mean, we all know this now, but as a newbie, I didn't understand, and she helped me understand, never do perpetuities. Look at the camera as soon as it starts rolling. Do not look away. I remember that very much so. And she talked about marketing to people. And somebody mentioned something about the follow-up that she would do, texting and things like that. That was really big with her. And that's something else that has stuck with me, the follow-up after an audition or after, you know, somebody comes to see you. Those kinds of things are super important. How to do a proper slate. I get a lot of compliments on my slates and it's all because of her. I'm really, you know, shocked like everybody else and saddened because I was going to come take a refresher of her audition course. Because I've been getting a lot more commercials lately. And I just said, well, you know, maybe I need to refresh my skills and see what's new. So just, I'm saddened that I can't send people to her either, because she's just somebody that we all needed in this industry. So thank you very much for letting me speak about her.
Thank you, Carrie. God bless. But remember, she's still there, folks. Just tune in. She'll give acting lessons from heaven.
Is absolutely. It okay if I comment one comment real quick? Is that okay?
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say that
that I know that not, it's been a while since I've been to the mixer or been involved in it, but just know that I've been involved through the marketing with her website. So I hope that you guys know and or appreciate, or I mean, not appreciate, but just know that I feel like I already know all of y'all just because of, you know, being with her, you know, like she had, of course she had like different ways of helping me. And I felt like, I was like, okay. I was like, are you teaching me how to act in this situation or something? Am I going for a role or but that's like, so I feel like I'm not just like the marketer, the website, you know, her website person or marketing person. I also feel like a student of hers too, because she, you know, she helped create that, that role in life too, to help you get to grow into it. I'm so sorry. That's all. I'm sorry.
Okay. Hey, do get in touch with me, girl. You can Google Gary Wimmer Austin. You'll see my website.
Oh no, I already have you in my email because okay. I was going to be a speaker. I'm sorry.
Email me and we'll figure out how to get the pictures to you. Okay, God bless all y'all for coming. Veronica, Gary, I'd like you to close it out for us, sweetheart.
Gary, before you close, can I speak? It's Marla. I didn't realize I was under Zoom. Mm-hmm. I met Donise when Samantha was 12. She's almost 20. I know, I can't believe it, but her first class, she said, I have somebody special here for the kids. If you want to trust me, get the hell out of my class and leave your kid. Veronica Age's mom's on here, and that's when we bonded. Yeah, and Samantha left the room. She had a really hard time with this, but she saw the chair that we made Donise. I know Veronica has it behind her, the other Veronica. I have such a void not having her here. She wasn't just an acting coach. Samantha took her class 7 times. She was a human being. She kept telling me, stay on Michael Druck. He will direct you. Stay on Michael Druck. Yes, you want to go with that agent you're with. Yes, it was never negative. I used to tell people, because they're like, do you go to California to act? It's like, no, I'm in Texas now. Donise was always the best secret. I used to tell everybody, I have a secret. I will share her with you, but you got to do what she says. And I would stay at the same hotel after the mixes with her. We would go into the room and we would drink some more vodka and smoke some more cigarettes. I quit. I promised her I would quit. I did. Only 24 hours I've quitted, but she's my angel. She's my source. And I love that my daughter has grown into a human, to an adult in the eyes of Donise. And somebody asked on the cutting across, where can you get her book? I'm fortunate I have like 7 of them signed. Because each one of my 6 kids and my husband took her class. But you can go to Amazon.com and put in Donise's name and buy it for $15. You don't want to be without that Bible. It's good to see everybody. Gary, you look great. I didn't see Judith. I saw Tootie. Oh my God, the animals drove Donise crazy, but she always made me bring stuffed animals for Tootie. I miss my friend.
We all do.
Thank you.
And Tootie bends over backwards for the teddy bear thing. If you want to mention anything about that, Tootie, you certainly can.
Yeah, Donise had allowed me the opportunity to collect stuffed animals for the veterans, and it started in 2015. And as a result, altogether, we've collected over 6,000 plus stuffed animals that went to the veterans in hospice, CLC.
God bless you, girl.
And a nursing home.
Tootie, you're gonna make me cry. Oh wait, I already am.
She also helped me and my business, Umbrella Media, with the Bastrop fires here in Bastrop, Texas, when our business, we started Central Texas Fires Foundation fundraiser to collect everything and anything, because there wasn't very many drop-offs of things. And so for the ones that, you know, they lost their homes. And so just because of her word, there, I mean, like our off, my office, like, you know, we got a lot of people and it was so amazing. Like just in like, it didn't even seem like it was like 2 weeks, maybe it was like 20 grand of like items and stuff that we could, we start donating to people, and gift cards and like, you know, clothing and diapers, you know, just anything and everything. And it was just like, so she, so I'm right.
Also, there. Also, I'm thinking of monologues, the Meals for Monologues. Forget the title of it, but I had volunteered. She asked me to volunteer for one of those, and it was wonderful, giving an opportunity to the, all the actors to come in,
for
casting directors, but also doing charitable work.
Yes,
was excellent.
Something like monologues for meals, or something.
Yes,
like
that. Monologues, yes. For meals. I think is, yes, what it was, yes, called. Yes.
Yeah, mine was Central Texas Fires, but it was not monologues. It was like more of, she just got the word out to help volunteers to come do it. But I would have loved that, though, the monologues. Hey, if you still want to volunteer for monologues, I'm sure I can use it somewhere.
I also want to say something about Tootie, though, her work. I mean, Tootie had, this is Angela Garza, and I'm on the iPhone right now. But Tootie's work, she had us. Yes, she had cities collecting stuffed dolls for these veterans, and what Tootie would do, that's going to make me cry. And the way Donise and everybody would get together to get these stuffed, you know, dolls to these veterans, and where were we, Tootie? Like in Temple, or passing these out, and I got to go along with her, and you should have seen these folks. I mean, how grateful they were, and my gosh, and the way that Donise would just get involved everywhere to help so many people, truly amazing what she would do, just truly amazing. And Tootie, you are amazing beyond words as well. I just want to say that.
Thank you.
I second the motion.
I third the motion. God bless you, Tootie. God bless all you folks for tuning in tonight. We certainly appreciate
it. I've got a little bit more. Wait, we're not quite done.
No, but there is a link that I posted in chat that has all the past Zoom mixers. And once I edit this, it will be available as well.
Absolutely. I would like to share with you from Carol Hummel. These were friends, longtime friends of Donnie's from the West Coast. It says from Carol, Donise was the most generous film buddy and personal friend that Bob and I have ever known. She was always available to cheer us up or help problem solve during some very lean years when work was slow. She went out of her way to share her professional leads to help Bob get work, and she was so sincere and loyal to both of us. Donise also loved one of my scripts, The Poet, that she tried to help us find funding sources for. She used the sides from the script in her acting classes, and I was thrilled to know she did that. Most of all, no matter time nor distance, she remembered her friends and reached out to make sure they were doing okay. And her beautiful smile and large throaty laugh. I'll miss my beautiful friend, but know her journey will be another grand adventure. Carol Hummel. And I also have something I would like to share. Excuse me, cedar fever, hello Texas, from her friend Pato in Bolivia. One moment here, let me get set up.
Hello Austin, greetings of Thanksgiving.
Can you hear this?
Pato Hoffman checking in from La Paz, Bolivia, down under in South America, truly down under. Big high sign to everybody at the network, Austin Mixer, and the celebration of life of Donise Hardy. I've had the pleasure of meeting and working with many of you back in the late 90s and early part of this millennia. And I still remember and cherish all of you. I'm checking in, obviously, for Donise Hardy's celebration of life. And not to want to hog up the limelight or anything, but I think aside from Veronica, and thank you, Veronica, for organizing this. Aside from Veronica, I'm one of the people who know Donise the best at the mixer anyway. I know I've met Donise back in the 80s, early to mid-80s, wow, in San Francisco, where she became my very first agent in my fledgling career as an actor when I was studying at ACT. And my biggest supporter ever since. I later moved on to LA, signed up with an agent there. She moved on to being a casting director. And but she was all after, she also became my manager when things got really, really good for me. I'm glad to say that thanks to Donise, primarily thanks to Donise, and also, of course, my LA agent, I had a very successful career for several years, almost a decade. When things started to dry up a bit and I started to have doubts about what I was doing, she had moved on to Austin, Texas. She sponsored me as a teacher, as an acting coach in mm-hmm. LA, taught many hundreds of hours to many hundreds of students out there, well, actors in the Austin area. And then I finally cashed in my chips, decided that having a family was more important than a life, was more important than having an LA career or an acting career. Back to Bolivia in 2006. And have missed Donise and acting ever since, although she did come and visit me once. She did come and she did see Bolivia. She did travel around with me. We had a great time. I've been out of the business for many years and missing it terribly. Not LA, not the that part of the industry, the ugly part of the industry, but missed acting and missed particularly film acting, although I did a bunch of theater. That's as much as I can say about Donise and I in a short period of time. I had planned a story, a Donise story. My favorite Donise story was how we both literally survived the 1994 LA earthquake. Mm-hmm. She was living there and working there. I come down on business for auditions. She housed me as she had many, many times over the years. And we literally barely got out with our lives. We were living in Sherman Oaks, just about 2 miles from the epicenter of the earthquake. Building where she had her apartment fell to pieces. It broke like a cake, like an old banana bread cake or something. And so, and I could, talk about that for a long time. And looking back, it's funny. There was some funny episodes now since we survived it. But that is no longer my best Donise story. My best Donise story happened a few days ago, the day she was crossing over back to the beginning, back to the place where we all came from. I've been out of the business and missing it, as I've said. And I got a call. I got a cold call from a local casting director who is casting a film for the writer director is from Spain, but who resides in the UK. And all his films, he has a sizable filmography, are made or produced out of the UK. I get a call for an audition per the director's request for one of the two lead parts. It's a road movie, a little 11-year-old girl and myself, for my character. I have been waiting and praying for something to happen, a good chance. I did some small stuff locally, but I was waiting for something to come up, like on my way, at the same time scared. I don't think it's a coincidence at all that this happened right after Donise had crossed over. And here I am in the final stretches of the callbacks and we're talking, having long conversations with the director about the film and my character. And it's pretty much as good as a done deal. Even though I almost turned the callback down, this is the good part, though. I almost turned the audition down because I'm rusty, I'm out of the business, I have kids, I have a small business. And I was depressed because of Donise. I've been in some serious depression for several weeks. But then a friend of mine who I was confiding in about all of this pretty much sort of virtually slapped me, and said, what's wrong with you? He says, if you really care so much about this person who was your best friend and your best supporter, your most enthusiastic lifelong supporter of your career, what best way to honor her than to not only go to this audition, but to kick ass and to make sure you get this part, to honor her memory and all the effort and energy and time and even money she put into invested in you over the years for your career to blossom. And I realized she was right. So that's what I did. I came, I went to the audition, I kicked ass. I'm a shoo-in, but don't have a contract yet. And I will sure let everybody know when I do. We're shooting in the middle of this year here in Bolivia, a film that will be showing throughout Europe and then Canada and US. So that's my favorite Donise story. Donise Hardy, thank you so much. Even when you're not physically here, you're still looking out for me. You've always been my number one fan. And more importantly, you've always been my very, very best and dearest friend ever. I miss you terribly, but fortunately, my belief system tells me that I will see you again and you will be waiting for me when it's my turn to go. And I wish you well on your voyage, your one-year voyage to your destination. Once again, that's how I was taught. You will be traveling this year, and I'd like to ask everybody to keep her in mind. But let her go, not to mourn anymore. You can't hold her back. She's paid her dues here. It's time to go. She's I hope you've mourned plenty like I have. But now it's time to send her forth, and for the next four seasons, be thinking of her, be mindful of her, send prayers for her, so that her journey back to the beginning is a good one. And we will all be joined together again, Donise. Look forward to seeing you. But I miss you here on this earthly plane. I feel I just wish I had the chance to see you one more time. But So it is what it is. And thank you for this audition. And I will do you proud. Thank you, Austin. Thank you, Veronica. Thank you, Donise. Blessings to all. And so we meet again. Welcome. Take care. Bye-bye.
So wow. May I add a note to that? Is that a,
sure. Go ahead.
Wow. I apologize. I just wanted to show, on my desk here, I have two notes on the bottom of my monitor. One is to email Donise at a casting place. And the other one is that I put next to it for, you know, myself, but sorry. Which I'm sure is inspired by Donise, but it says the worst enemy we have is our own fear. And so, I mean, we all know that she, the strength that we encompass, I think all of us has she increased our, I'm sorry.
All good. All good, my dear. She'd be proud of you.
She gave us all increased our own strength. I guess what I'm trying to say is just that I'm just so happy that I was able. I woke up one morning and I was like, I want to call Donise. What is she doing? Like, I'm going to talk to her. And that was, and she's like, I loved that feeling. And I'm just grateful that I got to have the conversation.
Michelle, that's going to be the hardest part, being able to pick up the phone.
I
get that. Listen, she and I spoke, because for those that don't know, I used to own DVA Talent, but I've lived in Northern California for a while now. But we spoke almost every other day. And if I may jump in, and I also want to acknowledge Heather Collier, who has just posted a beautiful thing in the chat. If you're not checking out chat, please check it out. She and I spoke the day that Donise passed, and it was so, just to bring you all in. So I arrived December 2nd. She went into the hospital December 4th. Her amazing friend Susan had been watching out for her. And Susan and I made the decision, we need to take her, she needs to be seen. She had a fall in September. I'm not going to get into details. But she went into the hospital on the 4th, because I know there's a lot of questions, and I'm going to keep it pretty simple. While in the hospital, Donise suffered from a stroke. She would go up and go down. And Susan and I and Andrea and Audra, we never left her side. I had to go back. I stayed till the 14th, had to go back. My husband said to me, you need to get back to her. And I did. I came back December 31st. Susan picked me up at the hospital. That's the word. And brought me to the hospital.
Mrs. Susan,
right here. Oh, get in here, baby girl. So we're combining Donise's worlds right now, y'all. Hold on, I got to get you all on that gallery view, because I want you all to know what an incredible life Donise had. She lived an amazing life. And even before she got to Texas, which was really the cherry on the sundae for her, and her Sun City Gal Pal group. Oh yeah, I'm kind of part of that now somehow. I don't know what's happening. Okay, that would be Mary. But let me say this. I went from the airport to the hospital, and Susan and I were holding her hand, and Andrea had been there for several days, and Audra, to make sure she was never, never alone. We held her hand, sang. There was music. There was Frank Sinatra.
You didn't bring flowers, right?
No. Oh, okay, wait. Go grab the. Okay, so this is what y'all should have known about Donise. Donise did not like flowers, except for
they are coming.
The one flower she loved. Which way? Oh, this way. Oh, this way.
Turn it around the other side.
Oh. And that's what I was trying to hint at her.
Bird of paradise.
only flower she truly adored.
Bird of paradise.
Bird of paradise. It was anyway, so thank you. But
and, I'm glad I didn't send the flowers in because
here's the thing. Susan probably would have gotten them. That said, so Donise was surrounded by love and music and prayer when she passed over. And Michelle, I'm just.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Go ahead. No, just because I don't want this, because I want this for everybody.
I didn't mean to, I didn't realize.
Steph, who reached out to me, I want you to know, I prayed with her. And she waited for me to come. Within 30 minutes of my being there, she passed. And I want to thank everybody here who helped with that. But Heather Collier, for we shared our moment. And it's very hard. And I want to, I do have a few kind of notes here. I want to thank Marla for that chair. I will get it back to you eventually. Hang tight. She lived a full life, everybody. Texas was the cherry on the sundae, and all of you were the lovely flavor sprinkles. She loved all of you. She loved this acting community. And if she told you, gave you something encouraging, take it in, because she meant it. She was not someone who suffered fools easily or gave you bullshit.
She told me to give him hell.
Exactly.
Yeah. No,
you're baby girl. You and I will chat. But
that's what I loved about her. I just wanted to say that.
That's cool. That's true. And Lee, I see Lee here. And Babs wanted to say something. So I don't want to forget to let Babs say something before we wrap it up. But Lee, she loved you so much. And all the intern for her were her assistants. She was grateful and blessed with all of you in her lives. And she knew it. And Jason, it's good to see you. All of my old agent friends and whatever. It's so good to see y'all. It's so good to see you here to celebrate this woman who was tough. Not gonna lie. Not gonna lie. But you know what? She raised you to a level that made you successful. And Tootie, I see you crying. And I want to say thank you to Tootie and Gary for continuing the Austin Network Mixer. I've been at plenty back in the day. I know how much she loved it. And again, her friends, Joan and Ellie and Ellen and Diane, Pato, Carl, and probably other, her family, who I send amazing. I mean, I just send so many condolences to. It's hard to lose someone who makes such an impact. And here's the thing. She wasn't sure she made an impact. And I would remind her all the time how much you all loved her and what she brought to each of our lives, because I know what she brought to my life. And hi, Ellen, I see you. And I want to thank Ellen for being my partner in the past month in making sure that our girl was taken care of. So thank you, Ellen. And Christopher, I want to thank you for sharing that video. I had forgotten about it. And it was so nice to see. Sorry. It was so nice to see, even after I got out of the business. She talked about all of you with me. And she loved what she did. She loved teaching and passing on that knowledge. Okay. So, true stuff. So, the day she passed, Susan and I came to her house, and I'm in her, by the way, this is her house that we're in right now. And we unlocked the door because Susan's husband was coming, and a gust of wind came. And I've come here for
20 plus year. Well, no, she hasn't had it since she's had this for a while, but I've been coming here. Never saw this happen. Door blew open. Susan and I went, hi, Donise. Because you know she's going to come. Let's be honest, everybody. She's going to be in our lives forever.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Take what she gave to you and honor her. Sorry. And honor her by loving yourself. Because she loved you all so much. She told me about it. She told you about it. And believe it, because Donise didn't say things she didn't believe in. She was no bullshit. So if she told you, believe it. Run with it. Be successful. Love yourself. Whatever your path may become, whether it's in the industry or outside of the industry, love your path. Follow your path. And know that her words will be with you forever, because she loved you. And I saw Brad and Kim Burton here earlier, and I hope you're still on. If you and Laura and Heather, I see you guys here. Thank you for being here. Thank you all for being here to share the celebration that was Donise. And I ain't gonna lie, there were days we didn't celebrate. But take a moment and think back. No matter what was said, she said it with the goodness that in her heart, and she wanted you all to be successful. And she was an amazing woman. And I'm going to, as we go on, it's been kind of quick. And I appreciate Gary and Tootie for allowing this to happen tonight. And thank you all. And it'll be on their YouTube page. And I don't know how to save the chat here, but Tootie, if you could do that, that'd be awesome, because there've been beautiful words that you have all shared. And I want to thank Audra, her beautiful friend Audra, who has put together a little photo montage that I would like to share with you before we leave tonight. And I'm going to get your buns in here, girly girl, because we are now at Donise Point. And I will say to you, Gary, is there anything else that you wanted to say? Oh, wait, Babs wanted to say something. So don't go before Babs gets to say something. And all our old school Alliance members, hashtag love you. We made a difference. And I just want to say this too. Because Donise was the one who got us all together. Love her, like her, hate her, whatever. Donise made all of this happen. At some point, film incentives live in Texas, because Donise either cajoled us, encouraged us, or pissed us off. Let's be honest. And she made this happen in this industry, because that's who she was. And remember that. I remember marching on the Capitol. Some of you are old school enough, or old enough, whatever it is, to remember that. And I encourage all of you that are coming up to remember that. You are worth it. Know your worth, because that's what Donise thought of you. Continue that path, because that will be her legacy. And that is what she brought to all of our existence. And I appreciate that. And Gary, Babs, are you there? Baby girl, you want to say something?
I'm so glad I never pissed her off.
Fair enough, sister. Fair enough.
I have never faced that side, so I must be doing something right.
Babs, are you there?
I am right here. And everybody has said everything. There's really nothing more for me to say except to thank you all and to thank Gary and Donise for the mixers. They were terrific. We had so many opportunities to share the mixer, and they were really, really fun. And Veronica, thank you for putting this together and for what everybody had to say. I mean, there's nothing more that I can say that hasn't already been said. So thank you.
And Tootie, just so you know, this is Bob. Bob was with Donise in the hospital to comfort her. And Bob will be coming to you at some point.
Okay.
To share.
Thank you.
To share, because she loved nothing than supporting veterans. I mean, she loved many things, but supporting veterans was one of her favorite things. Her Uncle Woody, was very dear to her heart, and her family was very dear to her heart. And I do want to acknowledge her family, her brother, Patrick, Stephen, Justin, and his brothers, and her sister, Marion. But thank you all for being her industry family. She loved you deeply and madly. Honor her. Be strong. Believe in yourself, because she believed in you. And enjoy life, because life is short. You don't know what's going to happen. I'm going to check my notes real quick, Gary, just to make sure I got everything. I told you she was surrounded by love. She didn't suffer fools like easily. She lived a long and a full life. Well, not long enough, quite honestly. And Steph and Jeremy, she loved you guys very much.
It was full, because it was full with a lot of people that love her. So that's wonderful. So,
and just to be clear, when Donise started her heavenly journey, it was with lipstick and her hair done.
Yes. Thanks to you.
Because that's how we roll, and she trained us well. And Audra, okay, is this a new one? Okay, hold on a second. We are, Gary, if there's anything else y'all want to say, I do have a little montage for you when you're ready.
Go ahead, girl.
Okay, give me a second, because I just got a new one. So anybody else want to speak while I get this ready?
I'm just going to say this.
I have one thing to say. Cheers. Cheers to Donise.
Yes, cheers. So with her, some of her family here and some of the Golden Girls, she was never really a boaster, other than, you know, maybe Spike Lee would come up in conversation, or George Carlin. But just last night, one of the people that she cast in a short indie film with an unknown director, he was a presenter at the Golden Globes, and he's is in the Matt. I don't know if she, like, did she ever share that with any of you, as he rose to fame in Maverick. He plays Hangman. So she casted him in Jumping Off Bridges when I was working with her. And then something else, one of the fellow interns that worked with us, another part of her legacy, is a part of the Academy now, Lindsey Graham. Glenn Powell Jr. And Lindsey Graham is part of the Academy, and she had some kind words to share. I don't have them with me, but and she's casting award-winning movies. So her legacy, when you watch movies, I want you to be thinking about the casting director and think about Donise and how great she was at her job. So that's, I just wanted to make sure those
that casting director in heaven, not a bad gig, you know.
I wanted to make sure that everybody knew that it, yeah, knew those things. So anyway,
do you have it ready to go? Okay, if you are ready, we have a little something for everybody. Give me just a moment while Audra. I have my IT director here.
Yeah.
Okay. So first of all, again, I want to thank Audra for this presentation.
It's only partially done, but
it's okay. And listen, we're going to continue to fill this out. Maybe we'll be on the YouTube.
357 photos.
So oh my goodness. Okay. We're going to do our best here, but here we go, everybody. Give me just a moment. We're going to share screen. And just so you know, Donise loved you all. Wait, not yet. I'm like almost there.
Get the little icon.
Yeah.
Get the little icon. That works.
Okay, here we go.
Sucks a lullaby. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. Perfect for flying honeymoon.
They say,
come fly with me, let's fly.
I can hear you, just say no. It's all good.
Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. You just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
Bye bye boom.
Right? I know. Seriously, like I'm like, I need to take my pictures down.
I'll hold your hands. They're just like
my mother will start to
beautiful. What's your
and heart? Father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace.
So roll. Really I'd better scurry.
Beautiful, please don't.
Well,
hurt.
Maybe just a half a drink.
Put
more.
Some records on while I'm
the neighbors might think.
She was Miss Hollywood, y'all.
What's in this dream?
No camps to be had up there.
No wonder she got what she wanted, right? Just like that drink. Just like, hey, honey, give me a drink.
Your hair looks
swell. I ought to say no, no,
mind
no,
if I'm moving.
At least I'm going to say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out.
Baby, oh, but it's cold outside. I simply must
but
go.
Baby, it's cold.
There she is, Miss Hollywood.
The answer is no.
Look at that.
Those eyes, those eyes.
So nice and warm.
Look out the window at that storm.
My sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the door.
Waves upon a tropical shore.
My maiden aunt's mind is vicious.
It's not touchscreen.
Maybe just a cigarette.
Never such a blizzard before.
I've got to get home.
Baby, you freeze out there.
Say, lend me a coat.
It's up to your knees out there.
You've really been
grown. I thrill when you touch my hand.
But don't you see?
How can you do this thing to me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of my lifelong
at
sorrow.
At least there will be plenty in
if you caught pneumonia and
I really
died,
can't
get
stay.
Over that old doubt. It's cold outside.
Don't my way on you.
Georgia, the whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
Georgia on my mind.
I said, Georgia. Georgia,
Thank you. sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. In spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Why not use your mentality? Step up, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin. Yes, I've got you under my skin.
Pegasus. Love fishing. Okay, and there we go.
Yeah.
She traveled the world. On a sailboat called the Pegasus, for those of you that didn't know.
I had no idea. Now, when are we going to all sail now?
Okay, that'll be the next meeting.
Right, that's what I was going to say. I was going to say the next meeting on the Pegasus.
So much. Okay, this portion might just be for Donise. I'm just saying.
Woo!
It is.
Why not?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a good song.
These are all from Donise's personal photo albums.
Really?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, my gosh, how cool is that?
You all are getting a peek into who Donise
is. Yes. Oh, look at her.
There's, oh.
Woo-hoo. La la.
Hello!
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 Caliente!
Yes, Queenie! Yes, Queenie!
Oh, whoever it is, I don't know.
Oh, that's okay. We all know that hand. Audrey, you have outdone yourself. This is fantastic.
She was quite the catch. Quite the catch.
The way you smile, just be. The way you sing off key.
I know this is long, but obviously well worth it.
No, it's well. I was gonna say the same thing. It's worth it. I mean, it's not long at all. It's not long enough.
We may never, right? Never meet again. Shit, Carly, here. Who did?
I did. So that always keep the memory
of. Not too hair like that.
The way we danced till the morning. The way you changed my life. No, no, they can't take that away from me. No, they can't take that away from me.
Right? Right? Loved fishing. That's our girl. Oh, I love this photo. Ellie Joan. That's our girl. Look at those legs, that. Right?
I know, right?
Oh!
I had her cast my legs.
Okay, this is almost this is where so we're getting. We're wrapping it up here. Everybody, stay with us. This is amazing.
I don't know. We're saying. I'm saying.
Go back to the Chippendales.
Can come true. Oh my God!
Forever remember her that way, y'all.
That's a god.
I know. She always remembers her.
That was her mom.
For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind, if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams. And life gets more exciting with each passing day. Or on its way. Don't you know
she loves Egypt with all of her being.
I like that.
to be young
and London. Her Uncle Woody.
Wow.
As rich as you are, it's much by far to be young at heart. And if you should survive,
I love that you know.
If you know, you know.
Oh my God.
Storming the Capitol together. CJ and the Italian Cooking Club. Her brother and her uncle.
Her brother,
her friend Kathy. Her mother.
And if you should
see, oh my goodness.
105. Look at all you'll derive out of being alive. And here is the best part. You have a head start. If you are among the very young.
She loved working with all of you. Lee?
I love that photo.
That's a great photo.
Yeah.
That is Dan Eggleston, for those of you who are not in the know. Marla.
What a world, what a life I live in love. A wonderful thing, as long as I hang on to the string. I hear say so and so.
That's her mother and her father, y'all. Her father.
Got the world on a string.
Oh.
Sitting on a rainbow.
Her father. Her sister and me. Long time ago, and a long time ago.
Life's a wonderful thing.
Joan and Kathy.
Long as I hang on to the string. Dear silly so and so. If I should ever let it go.
That is her sister Sandy and brother Raul.
Got that string around my finger.
Pato! Her sister Sandy. Pato and crew.
Oh my God.
Oh, Donise! Many of you may not realize Donise was the head of a special needs organization for one of her stepsons. I don't have it in front of me right now, so please forgive me, but I'll post it later.
Before you came, my pound was running low.
She's a woman of many talents and a woman of many, her heart is a gold.
My bridges all across.
Okay.
To go.
So. Can you bring us one? Okay, we're at the end. Okay, this is her as a chef on Pegasus. She traveled the world on a sailboat. How amazing is that?
Why wasn't I invited?
Right?
Oh my gosh.
an accomplished businesswoman, philanthropist. Thank you. She was the Fiesta Queen. And it was the year they had over 100,000 people. Crowd of 100,000 turnout for the Fiesta Queen. Know that you were in the company of someone who gave back to the world.
Exactly.
And enjoyed the world and enjoyed what she did. Celebrate Donise Hardy tonight, everybody. She was amazing. Oh, that's my girl. And she loves Skippo. That was Lisa Vanderpump in Vegas. Oh, the girl knew how to set a table. If you know, you know.
My way, and I'm gonna wrap it up.
I want to say one thing with the sailing part. She's like the Amelia Earhart of the sea, but she survived. You know what I mean? Like, okay. Great.
Yes.
Sailor, right? You know?
Like, and I know, listen, I know this is long, y'all. Just bear with us. We are almost at the end, I am assured. And I want to thank Audra for putting this together. There we go. We're coming up here. Oh, she loved her Italian cooking club so much. This is part of her family.
Let there be me, let there be oysters.
Sorry, y'all, but her life was too fabulous for just a few moments.
There is nothing.
Let's be honest. That is her brother Patrick and her uncle Woody.
Chili con
carne. I'm not sure who they are, but they were on the horn blower. Oh, that was her Uncle Woody, who she adored, and he adored her. And her sister Sandy, and if you know, you know.
How did Donise?
That's our girl! That's our girl!
We need a little my way, though.
How did Donise end up back here in Austin?
Okay, let me stop sharing the screen. We'll do that later. We'll go out with that. Hold on, we're getting our IT situation going. There it is. What was the question?
I just wondered how Donise ended up here in Austin.
The quake. There was an earthquake in San Francisco. It scared her the bejesus out of her.
Oh, really?
And her sister was here in Texas, so she came to Texas.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because I used to, when I was in LA, I read for Donise a long time ago, and I think she might have been, she was probably in LA in 94 when we got the quake there, so that probably helped. Probably pushed her to Texas a little quicker too. Yeah.
Listen, her house shook, things fell off the wall. She grabbed the okay, hold up. I'm gonna bring y'all into her world for just a moment.
Okay, Vanna.
Yes.
What would you happen? Which
one? So this is it.
The scribe. The gentleman, the man in the corner.
Oh, so she grabbed one thing. Okay, wait. There he is. Oh, I didn't mean to bring him for. Okay, she's bringing him forward. Okay, we might have been here a little too long tonight. But she grabbed this gentleman and came to Texas. He's heavy.
There you go.
He ain't heavy, he's my brother.
Joel.
A group of her friends are here with us. Okay, Guy says he was in that San Francisco earthquake too, but the LA one was the final straw for her. She went to Austin then. She was two big quakes in a couple of years. Did anybody else have any other questions? Maybe before we turn it back to you, Gary. Sorry, Gary, I'm kind of taking over, but I appreciate you because it's Donise style.
girl, you spent a lot of time compiling that, putting that together.
That was Audra. Thank you, Audra.
God bless you. That was absolutely beautiful. You know, really was. So can't extend my thanks enough to you, Veronica, and to all you folks for tuning in. This will be on YouTube. I'm probably not going to edit it, so it'll be in its complete length.
No editing.
And if you want to see it all, you'll have to just go through it all. But I think we're going to end it at that. Okay, everybody.
All right, let me grab everybody, ladies. We're gonna pull it together. So, for her industry friends and family,
and toast to Donise,
and her Sun City girls, and her. I'm gonna get everybody in here if I may. Yeah, we just want to say thank you again to the Austin Network Mix. Okay, hold on, it's a whole thing here. Okay, Donise would be on us. Okay, and bring it in. So that said, to all of the faces that I see and I know, and all the ones that I don't know, but I heard a lot about, thank you all for remembering how amazing our girl was. She loved the industry. She gave it her all. She shot from the hip. She was loyal as hell. And she loved hard.
And that happened.
Apparently she's saying wrap it up. She's saying wrap it up. Ladies, reel it in. And I'm going to say this to Gary and Tootie and all of you. Live long. Love hard. Be successful, believe in yourself, have lots, and live it all, because that's what Donise would want. So thank you all, and thank you.
Cheers.
Amen.
Cheers.
Thanks to all you folks for tuning in.
Cheers.
Certainly appreciate it.
So ladies and gentlemen.
This will be on YouTube, so I will.
Thank you, Gary, for just a moment. This is the last song that Donise heard, and it was a specific request that I play it at any celebration of life.
I can go where life beats me somehow.
Do it your way, y'all.
Once I can touch what my heart used to dream of.
That's not my way. Hold on. That's not the right one. Hold on. Stop that one. Stop. Lady, stop. Okay. I'm putting you all. Alexa, volume 10. Sorry, y'all. Yes, it is.
And now, the end is here. So I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step
along the byway. And more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way.
Alexa, stop.
Sing it.
Nope. Oh. Okay. So I'll leave it at that, Gary, because that's how she did it. Thank you all for listening, and I will see you all soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Veronica. Thank all you folks for tuning in. Everybody bow their head. Donise, we love you. You're still with us. And thank you so much. Have a good evening, folks.
Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Good night, Donise.
Donise.
Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you.
Good night, everyone.
We love
from
you,
the
Donise.
West Coast. Good night.
Love you, Donise.
Thanks a lot. Good night. Thank you, Gary.
Hey, Carl.
Thank you, Veronica.
Thank you all.
Thanks, everybody. Thank you. Love you, Donise.
Thank you.